Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association Duckpin Challenge. We're coming to you from the T-Bowl lanes on the Berlin Turnpike in Newington, Connecticut. This is my partner, Craig Self, and I'm Norm Peters, and together we'll be bringing you all the colorful and exciting action. How do you see our bowlers today, Craig?
We've got Frank Barrows back, left-handed bowler, bowling off his left foot, rather unusual.
Very.
He's bowling against Tom Dominique from Willimantic, a powerful bowler. The winner of that first match is going to try the Torrington Tornado, Jim Groves Jr.
A very, very strong bowler indeed.
Right.
And you'll be seeing all our bowlers in action if you stay with us. And we'll be right back in just a moment.
We're back, Norm.
We're going to
have a slow-mo of our first bowler here in a moment, our number three seed, Tom Dominique from Willimantic, Connecticut. Powerful bowler. He starts off on the right-hand side of the approaching ball, crosses over to the head pin. Frank Barrows, Jr., you notice the left foot extended to the foul line and delivery from the left hand. And Jim Groves, Jr., right down the middle, powerful, powerful. We call him the Tornado.
Frank Barrows is going to be a very interesting bowler to watch, very unorthodox style, as you said, with the left foot.
We saw Frank back at the end of April. He was on one of our very first shows and started the match against Ben McDonald with three consecutive strikes. That's bonus money.
Oop.
Frank stuck. He's got to make sure of his footing here.
Can't start any better than that.
True to form.
Here it is again. Look at his form.
Apparently that sticking didn't bother him.
Not at all. It looked like he was going to have a nine there for a minute, but the old ducks went flying.
Yeah, when the five pin goes last, you know you've got a pretty good hit.
Tom Dominique, a very strong bowler. He didn't get the luck on that first ball that Frank had.
We got that's fairly straight delivery from the right-hand corner of the approach right to the head pin. Of course, it came a little light that time.
Not a way to do it. A mark?
Everybody starts with a mark.
Mm-hmm. Frank Barrows with the strike, Tom Dominique with a spare, working on a spare.
Tom's from Willimantic, Connecticut. Bowls quite a bit at
Look at that. This is going to be an exciting tournament. Look at it again.
I was going to say, he bowls at the lucky strike lane. There's nothing lucky about this strike. Watch it, right into the pocket.
Picture perfect. That's how they write the book. Here it is again.
This is a replay of his first frame into that 1-3 pocket, and the five pin goes last.
There it is.
Now, if he does that again, he gets some bonus money.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the bonus money. Three strikes in a row will give you $50. $50 each for additional strikes. If you get all marks, strikes or spares in a row, you get $200. You don't get them, the bowlers get them.
Well, He's got a chance here to continue his marking frames.
This is proving to be a very exciting game right now. The first place finisher comes up with $400 today, the second place finisher $200, and the third $120. So our scoring money is
Dominique,
there.
High single game, 220, and a high three set of 525. Just another two pinner.
Not an easy spare, but it's makeable.
Well, at least he comes in from the right hand side. So.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Norm, we almost saw it.
Mm-hmm.
Now the third ball in duck pens to add a little bit to your score.
Hate to use a trite expression, close but no cigar.
The second ball, the spare shot was closer. Okay, now he's going to look to come right back. Doesn't want Frank Barrels Jr., the senior, to drop the hammer on him in the fourth frame.
Oh, what a bad split.
Well hit. Well
look at
hit,
it again.
But I know this one well.
Don't we all?
Both of those could have gone.
Nice try.
That's the kind of action you want to get. You want to get the pen back up on the deck so that it has a chance to come over and hit the other one. Average, that composite average is for the entire bowling year of 1984-85. All of his tournaments and all of his league averages averaged out to be 141. Pretty hefty average.
Now it's Frank Barrow's turn to see if he can catch up to Tom.
Another spare lead.
Mm-hmm. Very makeable spare.
Even a 4-7.
Notice how he lands. He ends up on the left foot, the same side as the arm that is delivering the ball, which is a very unorthodox style.
Started that back when and became very accustomed to it, and that's all that matters is if you have
that's
that
right.
consistency of delivery. I did bowl with Frank one time at the Barnum Lanes in Bridgeport or Stratford when he rolled seven consecutive strikes for a 225 game.
Accuracy is the name of the game, and he's got it. Okay, we'll continue on with all of the action here at the T-Bow Lanes in a moment. There's your scores as they stand, and we'll be right back after these messages with a fifth frame.
We're back. I'd like to urge all of our viewers to stop in if they're in Torrington or Stratford or Cheshire at the local bowling lanes, arcade lanes on Main Street up in Torrington, and Barnum Lanes down on Barnum Avenue in Stratford, and Cheshire Lanes on Milldale Road in Cheshire. That's Route 10.
Tom Dominique comes back up to the line.
Tom Dominique. Uses Paramount bowling balls.
He's up against some tough competition. Want to look at it again? Here's what it looks like. Another beautiful strike.
And the five pin went last. That's nice.
Winner of the Gillette's handicap.
Back in 1982.
Mm-hmm.
Tom tries hard. He's always trying hard. He gives 100%, 10% of every effort.
I'm talking to him. He says he just wants to throw the best ball possible, which is about average for every bowler.
That was right in the pocket. They had a chance at a double that time. They'll shoot the 5-8 for a spare.
His approach is slight cross alley from right to left.
He's down 30 pins in the fifth frame. Boy, that's not lucky.
Not at all.
Pick that object pin right off. 75 through five frames. 85 through six. Now Frank Barrows is 96 plus in the fifth frame.
One duck didn't fly.
And again, it's the five pin.
He's taking a good hard look at it.
Six accuracy. Marks in a row for Frank Barrows Senior.
105.
We got all these juniors and seniors around here. We've got Jim Groves Jr. and I know that there's Frank Barrows Jr. too. That's why every once in a while I throw that out there. He's a bowler.
Good spare coming up.
This one is a little bit more difficult. He's either going to try and have the pin go back. If he crosses over like he does with his normal first ball, he'll have to rely on the pin going over to take out the eight. If he comes in on the left-hand side.
Oh, he did it.
What a perfect shot. Oh.
Here comes a replay from the side. Watch Frank. Notice that form.
Well, you've just seen Frank Barrows Sr. deliver seven consecutive marks. However, if you're starting off as a young bowler, do not imitate that style.
unless you can keep it consistent.
You probably take your ankle off with the ball.
Especially if you're righty, don't imitate that style.
Mm. Tom ran into a buzzsaw today.
He sure did. It's not easy bowling against a guy who has all marks from the beginning until the present, the sixth frame.
And don't forget, the winner of this match takes on Jim Groves Jr.
The buzzsaw himself.
Tornado.
Guys, it's Kim. It's $200 bonus money for an all-mark case.
Yes,
now
right.
We've got to pay particularly close attention to Frank's score. There's a bonus of $200 if he can get 10 marks in the game.
I hope he's not thinking about it.
Well, let's not.
Let's not tell him.
Let's not tell him.
Could ruin it.
I think Frank is just looking to shoot as high a score as he possibly can and get prepared for Jimmy Groves.
Let's do him one better. $10,000 at the world record of 267. Is broken in a single game.
That's out of reach here, but
that's out of reach.
But he could conceivably shoot a 200 game, which we are still looking for our first 200 game on the challenge. Frank's a lab tech over at Uniroyal in Naugatuck.
That did it.
No, it didn't.
No, it didn't. No. He's got a spare possible, right?
If you're a lefty, winner of the lucky strike, B, 82, again in 84, Teller's B.
Look.
See, oh, oh, oh.
I can't believe this.
Frank Barrows Sr. Wow, what a shot.
Want to see how he did it?
I was going to say, if you're a lefty, this is
that's perfect.
Perfect for you. You got to just shoot it right over there, and he is deadly today.
He just
8 marks in a row, 2 more.
Kicked it right over.
Come on.
Look at this. Another strike.
Well, you know what one more mark does?
Yeah.
Gives him a bonus.
$200.
Look at that. Look. Now, you recall early in the match, he was crossing over the head pin into the 1-3 pocket. Now he's back over into the 1-2 pocket.
Tom looks bothered by all this, and I don't blame him.
Tommy's an observer at this point.
Oh. Strong. Fifth pin standing there.
Incidentally, Frank Barrows was the high qualifier at the Metro qualifying meet for this particular show. Shot for 5 games.
Good boy.
Shot a 776 total. And Tom Dominique was only a few pins behind him with a 759 total.
Mm-hmm. Frank Barrows started bowling at the age of 25. He's got a lot of time on the lanes.
I think he's only about 28 now.
Yeah, sure. Do you have any idea how old Tom is?
You want me to take a wild guess?
Late 20s, maybe?
I'd think so.
Middle to late 20s.
I've seen some of the girls leave out their age on their initial profile sheets, but never a guy.
Tommy tried coming in on the left-hand side on that one, and it didn't work.
Tommy's had these. Wide. Tommy's had a lot of two-pinners to shoot at, but they haven't been together.
He wouldn't have done that if he aimed.
Well, Tommy finishes with a respectable 129, and now
Frank is working on $200 bonus money for all marks. I hope he doesn't hear me.
The suspense is mounting.
He's got one more shot at it. And that is a bad shot at it.
This makes it difficult. Now, a good first ball delivery has a fairly good chance of making this, converting this spare.
It can happen. Ooh, one more.
That's a $200 penny he's looking at.
It
looks like it wants to become a part of the building over there.
Wait till we break the news to him. Shall we? One pin between him and $200.
What an excellent try to convert that spare, though. 190 for the match.
Okay, that was pretty exciting, and he just missed $200. Frank Barrows Sr. did, and we'll be continuing with all the bowling action after we come back after these messages. For our television viewing audience, you'll be happy to know that an exciting new book is available to you about duckpin bowling. This book is called Duckpins, The 10th Frame, and it's an attractive vinyl edition which contains feature stories by duckpin's finest bowlers ever. Some of those stars include Nick Tronsky, Swede Labors, Lou Gehsig, and Wilder Garrett, just to name a few. Along with these featured stars are many others too numerous to mention. You'll also find thoughts about duckpin bowling from many Pro Tour winners. To order your copy, send a check or money order for $12.60. That's $12.60, which includes postage and handling as well as a contribution to Connecticut Duckpin Youth Bowling. Send it to Post Office Box 11431, Newington, Connecticut, 06111. Again, the address, Post Office Box 11431, Newington, Connecticut, 06111.
All right, here's the match we're looking for. The final today between Frank Barrow Sr. and Jim Groves Jr. Jim Groves, the man who makes the pins fly up into the corners and back out onto the deck.
He's contending with a very strong bowler by the name of Frank. Look at this, Frank, what do we got here?
That's just Jim Groves Jr.
He's a hurricane, a tornado, a buzzsaw. That's how he did it. He doesn't leave any standing waiting for the duck to fly over.
I've said it so often, he's the 20-year-old man with a 140-some-odd average. He's going to be one of the top performers around in years to come.
I think Frank cannot be ashamed of what he did in the last game when he came up with a 190 score and just missed the $200 bonus score by one pin. But I think he knows what he's up against.
Well, two frames in a row now, Frank has missed the head pin.
Yep.
The last frame of the first match and now the first frame of this match.
Mm-hmm.
So if he can get back on, we'll look for a good match. Of course, the one thing he's got going for him, he's shot a 190 game, as you mentioned. That's higher than any of the games that Jim Groves has rolled to win his previous championships.
Up.
Spare leaf.
That's a makeable spare.
Oh, triangle right. All he has to do is get a piece of the six pin.
Six, the nine, and the ten standing. Nope. Too far to the left. I hope he's not intimidated being up against Jim.
Concentration may have slipped away for a moment or two. Came back. He used his third ball to add to that pinfall. 10 for the frame, 20 for two frames.
Which is average.
I'd hate to say that's par. I mean, that's the most you can get in a frame without marking.
That's right. Here's Jimmy. High single game, 215. High three game set, 538. James Groves Jr. It's a very strong delivery.
Yeah, completely missed the head pin. Went ripping through the 3-9, but still had enough on it and enough flyback to leave himself a triangle on the left side.
4-7-8.
It's just such a powerful ball that he gets a little extra.
He's going to try to tip that 4 from the right-hand side, being a righty. Head on. Did not work.
He got the pick.
I'll try to hit the 8.
The good guys bowled yesterday anyway. You saw all the good guys bowled.
Okay, Jim's going to look to get back on track here. But that open in the last frame should help Frank get back into this.
Mm.
They're made out of a composition of acrylic and whatnot. They've got to be fairly strong.
He bowls with a lot of authority in his arm. A lot of authority.
This is another case to young bowlers. Don't try to go out and imitate Jim Groves Jr. either initially, because the one thing he's developed in the last couple of years is a very definite, slow approach. And then he has a strong delivery. A lot of young people will get up there and they'll run as fast as they can to the line and try to throw the ball as hard as possible, but they've lost all their balance in that run to the foul line.
Which he doesn't do, of course.
No, he's got that approach really under control.
Highly composed, yes, highly composed.
Frank's back on the pocket.
Yeah, here's a replay of it. One pin left standing. It looked like the 10, wasn't it? Yep.
Sure is. Yep. This is a natural for Frank.
coming in from the left.
Yep.
There's the score as it stands now.
8-pin difference.
Right down the middle. Frank Barrows, senior, is from Naugatuck, as we said. He works at the Uniroyal lab. He's a technician there. He's got a possible spare here. Wrong way to do it.
Unfortunately, he didn't gain anything on his mark.
No.
Okay, Jim Groves, Jr.
I'll take that back. That wasn't a possible spare. That was a third ball.
Beautiful.
There it is again. Another replay. Watch this. Ducks did their job. Working on a spare. Coming back after the spare.
Again, he was off on the three pin, but he had enough power to get the action. Some of us would just go right through that three and nine, and that's all we'd have is two pins.
Jimmy qualified with a 756 for today. Go ahead.
Turnpike lanes B at the age of 15, and I question the legality of that.
All right. We're in our fifth frame, and we'll be back to continue the action with Frank Barrows Sr. in just a moment. Here's a review of some of the duck pin bowling centers you can practice in and learn the game if you want. Johnson's Lanes, Dixville Avenue, Hamden, Highway Lanes, Route 12, Plainfield and Laurel Lanes, Main Street in Winston.
Great fun, Norm. Go out on a weekend or sometime during the day. Most of the houses have leagues going during the winter season. So it's kind of difficult to go out on a weeknight, but weekends and daytime, open bowling.
Great way. Well, great way to spend a party, too.
Oh, you know.
If you have a birthday party or something like that, and you want to get the gang out and do something unusual, go bowling.
Especially for children's parties. Here's Frank. Mm-hmm. Frank going for the spare, the five pin. He's got his game back. Now, he does not want to do what he did last time. He won the Teller's mixed doubles, the Johnson's mixed doubles. He's an excellent mixed double bowler.
He's coming back again, all right.
His daughter Debbie's a bowler also.
Looks like the whole family is.
Just about. I think he has one daughter who does not bowl.
He started bowling at the age of 8. I'm sorry, I'm looking at the wrong sheet. I got the wrong person. Let me get over to Frank Barrows Sr.
There
I said before, he started bowling at the age of 25.
All right, Frank has a score right now, 67 through six frames. Jim Groves through five frames is 68 plus.
Almost.
It's not over yet. Spin, no? He's hollering kick. he wants one of the pins to kick the other one so that it'll drive it back into that eight pin.
There, it kicked.
It kicked.
It kicked, but it didn't happen.
Not enough kick.
Stayed with it until the last second.
That's all right. He's got a 19 pin lead.
The winner of the Winsted Mixed Doubles, Jim Groves Jr.
Okay, Jimmy's been on the Pro Tour now for a couple of seasons. He's been in probably nine tournaments. These are tournaments that are in Maryland and Washington and Virginia and Rhode Island, Massachusetts. He's qualified to be in the final day three times, and last week he finished 20th out of 155 or 60 bowlers.
I guess it helps when you're the assistant manager of the Torrington Bowling Center, as he is. He gets plenty of bowling time in. Some of his hobbies are fishing, coin collecting. He's a solo soprano player for the Connecticut Vagabonds.
Okay, he's in command here again, Norm.
Boy, he sure is.
He's got, right now, 93 to 67 that in the sixth frame. That's a 26-pin difference. Frank must convert these marks. I've been a little out of it here for a few minutes, Norm. I've been trying to clarify the scores, and I've got them under control at this point. I saw two different scores.
Yes. Well, you didn't do it right there.
Let's get our 10 for the frame and move on to the next and hope we can mark out.
Hmm. It's coming. Moving into the eighth frame.
Gracious, he was so full on the head pin that he left a little bit on each side.
There's a possibility of a spare. It's not an easy one.
In the first game, I would say he would have made that.
Yes.
You could see he was really on in that first game.
He couldn't do anything wrong at that point.
He made two very difficult spares. He almost converted a difficult spare in the 10th frame.
Well, you have to remember this is his second game and Jimmy's first game, and Frank could be a little tired.
Well, I don't know. I think I'd always rather go in with a game under just to warm up. I think it's harder to come in cold and bowl that first game well.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they did practice for up to an hour on different lanes prior to the TV match.
Some people come on strong, though, without having to warm up, and I think maybe that might be Frank's situation. Jimmy is real strong still. Here's another look at it.
This is it, right in there. He missed the object pin with the first, but he came right back on it. Now, Jimmy, normally in the previous, I guess he's won four titles now. He always shoots somewhere between 145 and 165, and he's on target. One mark. Mark here, and he's right back up there, 140s, 150s.
He's got a spare in the works. Here's another look at it.
1-2 pocket, and look.
Pin didn't make it.
Came right in front of the 10 pin.
Dead eye.
Just another day at the office for Jim.
The normal bowler, you know, when I say normal, meaning not the pro, an everyday bowler would probably let up.
Meaning like us.
Yes. on that one pin standing, try to bowl it slow, but notice the force that he goes in with it to get that pin down. He doesn't let up at all.
You're referring to my missing that yesterday, right?
Not really.
Twice? Okay, Frank, come on, babe. Just another two-pinner.
I'm going to contend that he's tired. Go out on a limb and say he is tiring.
The bright lights.
The television, yeah. But he wasn't nervous in the beginning. Frank winds up with a 93. Almost.
Well, Jim Groves is going to defend his championship here successfully today. Come back in a couple of weeks. What a spare. See, now, if he had that in the 10th frame of the previous match, why, he would have won $200.
That's right. But one pin still.
You probably ran over between these two matches and told him he lost $200. And they, oh,
no
goodness.
Way. I wouldn't
Good
want
finish.
Anybody to do it to me, and I wouldn't do it to them. We'll tell them after it's all over.
Frank finishes with a 111 game. Frank is probably going to wonder about this because I recall when he was in our match in April, he finished out with a 111 game.
Mm-hmm.
There's something, a bit of a jinx on him at this moment. Look how powerful this guy is. He's got 140 through 9, and if he converts this, he's got 150 plus for the match.
Beautifully bowled.
Jim Groves Jr. adding all he can. 156 to 111.
Okay, we'll be awarding some prizes in a little while and also having our spare challenge. We'll be back in a moment for it all.
Well, we're back with Connecticut Travel Services Spare Jackpot. We've changed the configuration of the split a little bit. It was 5-7-10. Now it's going to be 4-7-10. The prize, two tickets to anywhere in the United States that U.S. Air flies. And right now, we've got our three bowlers from the previous match going to participate in the Spare Jackpot. Tom Dominique from Willimantic, our first attempt. He wants to hit the four pin light on either side and get the other pins in motion. Great attempt, but he drove them both into the corner. And Frank Barrow Sr. will give it a try. Had this occurred in the first match, he might have made it with no trouble at all. Let's see if he can do it here. Great try, great try. Now he tried it the other way. Exactly the opposite from what Tom Dominique did. Tom went in on the right-hand side of the object pin, and Frank went in on the left-hand side trying to slide the four pin all the way over to the 10 pin. Jim Groves would just try to hit it real hard and watch him fly. Almost came back up on. Great tries by all the bowlers.
Okay, and there you have our spare jackpot. And we also have a sales representative from US Air, Mr. Dan Quintiliano, who is coming out here now and going to talk to us about US Air. And Craig Self is also coming out, and he's going to do some awarding of some of our prizes. Hello, Dan.
How are
Welcome.
You? Pleased to meet you. Pleased to be here.
Tell us a little bit about US Air and what you were doing with Connecticut Travel Services and how you got around to bringing us this jackpot.
Well, it's just a joint promotional tie-in where Connecticut Travel wanted to get involved with this tournament, I assume, and they've asked us to cooperate with them, which we've decided to do.
Mm-hmm. It's a fine, fine tournament that you're helping sponsor here, and we appreciate all of your efforts, and we hope you'll continue with us for a long time.
We certainly hope to. It's a pleasure to be here. We've seen some good bowling, and I enjoyed it myself.
Thank you, Dan Quintiliano.
Thank you for having
me
here.
Right. Thank you. Craig, come on in here and tell us about some of our winners right now. And
okay.
We are awarding them.
Be happy to. Dan, we're going to award our bowlers today checks in the amount of $400 for the first place, $200 for second place, and $120 for third place. Now, presenting our first check to Tom Dominique for $120 for finishing third.
Tom. Congratulations, Tom.
You ran into, Tom,
stay here, Tom.
For a second. You ran into a real buzzsaw today in that first match.
Yeah.
How'd you feel?
I was throwing the ball well, but it's typical. I bring out the best in everybody.
Well, you did today, that's for sure.
That's for sure.
He
okay.
rolled a 225 against me one time.
So. I don't feel as bad.
No. Thank you, Tom.
Thank you very much.
Tom.
Second place today, Frank Barrows Jr. Senior. Frank.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Frank.
Thank you.
You really had a very high score today, and it didn't seem as though anything was bothering you at all in the first game. What happened in the second game?
I wasn't throwing the ball out. If I ever could get past the second game, I'd be dangerous because then I'd only have to bowl one game.
Were you thinking about anything unusual or anything bother you at all?
No, not really.
You weren't intimidated?
No.
By Jim at all?
No, I've bowled with Jim before.
You have, I figured you must have.
No, it's just a question. Just have to throw that ball out.
Okay, and you weren't getting it out there just well enough then, huh?
Right.
Frank,
okay.
Yes.
Did you realize that if that 10 pin went, you had a $200 bonus in the last frame of the first game?
No, I didn't.
You missed it by one pin. We hate to break that news to you. If that one pin had gone down in the 10th frame of the last game, you would have had a $200 bonus. Unfortunately, it didn't go down. And here's the man that broke the news to you.
Come back and try again. Thank you, Frank.
Thank you, Frank.
Mr. Tornado, Jim Groves Jr.
Congratulations, Jim.
Congratulations.
Jim, this is your fifth check for the winner's amount. Congratulations. You started off just like you always do, with a strike right in the first frame. Blew the pens all over the place. How do you do that?
I throw the ball hard, eat my Wheaties for breakfast. You have to get here early.
You've psyched everybody. You've bowled pretty well with that first frame strike every time. Seems to set them up for sure defeat. Is it something you consciously try to do with that first two frames?
I think it's early? Important. Yeah, it's important to get out of the gate strong and, you know, get a jump, early jump. It does a lot for ATN. If you got a lead, you know, put a little pressure on your opponent.
works well.
You
yeah.
concentrate well. You really
thank
do.
Thank you. Thank you.
You put a lot of concentration and a lot of effort, and it shows.
Thank
How many
you.
Years have you been bowling now?
This will be my 13th year.
13th year?
Right.
Wonderful.
Started when I was 8 years old.
Jim, tell us a little bit about the Pro Tour you're on now. You bowled this weekend past. What did you do there? How's that set up?
Okay, this is my second year on the Duckpin Professional Bowlers Tour, and I qualified for my first time in the second year, which I think is a big accomplishment for myself. I previously made the money 2 times before that, but you know, to make the cut for the first time, coming 20th out of 150 bowlers, it's a pretty good accomplishment.
Okay, once again, congratulations, Jim, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
And don't spend those $400 all at once.
I won't.
Thank you very much. That'll just about do it for today. We'll be back again next week.
Okay. I'd like to thank Dan for being here with us today, and we look forward to continued service. We'd like to see more of our bowlers take advantage of your trips. We've had one winner so far, and we almost saw a couple of close ones here today.
Okay. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We'll see you again next week. Bye-bye for now.